actually chose this script when I was in grade 10 because I fell in love with it, and every other script I read didn't own up to this. I'm not going to tell you guys what the play is about. You'll find out for yourselves. I love mystery. But the thing is when we're writing this blurb, we're supposed to talk about what we learned, and I learned a lot of things through this. I learned that it's okay to ask for help. It's okay to discover new things about characters and setting and stuff like that. And it's good to take advice. And most of all, I learned that I like directing better than acting. So you're probably going to see me backstage a little bit more. But I think the most thing is I discovered that no matter who you are, no matter if you identify as female or male, what religion or race or anything you are, we're all so different, but yet we can all come together and make a piece of art and put it on a stage. So this is my shout out to everybody who helped me with this. I love you guys. There is a warning. I have strobe lights, so if you can't, look at that. Look away, or leave, one of the two. I guess without further ado, Blood on Canvas.
Okay, arrivederci.
That's Italian.
Pardon?
She saw Spanish. I forgot she was Italian.
Spanish, Italian.
It's all right
too. Well, I must say, I'm a huge fan.
That's nice.
I just love all your paintings and all the other things that you do. I've been following your work in the press and I've been so looking forward to meeting you in the flesh.
Oh.
So is this where the magic happens?
Sometimes.
It's very twee.
Just how long have you been a fan?
Oh, forever. I just love what you do with paint, yeah.
And my sculptures!
Of course, I love those too!
And my painting sculptures.
So is this your work?
Just some of the ones I thought you'd like.
Huh. What's this one?
It's called Naked. It's an exploration of oneself. It's likely buried against the cold and licking universe.
It's very orange.
It is.
Is orange cold?
You're being too liberal.
Hmm.
Femme!
Femme?
Tripper. Feminine, or female, I suppose.
It's
blue. Yes, it's blue. I know it's not traditionally a feminine color, so it challenged my nation's gender.
Where do you come up with these wonderful ideas?
The nature of small things.
Small things, these dots, or atoms, molecules?
If you like.
So are all these yours?
Of course.
But they're all different. Different styles, different textures.
They were just painted at different times, which one of us is saying one day to the next.
What do you mean?
You know Pablo Picasso?
Of course.
He was a different artist at a different stage of his life. Blue period, rose period, analytic cubism, synthetic cubism. Sometimes I can go for that a week.
So what would you call these? I mean, they must have a fancy name.
What would you say they were?
I don't know. Cubism? No, of course not, that's stupid. Abstract?
Bingo!
So these are all abstracts?
Yes!
Oh, I see.
So, what did you say was your favorite?
I couldn't choose. I love them all.
Minimiro?
I don't know.
Cezanne, Vermeer, and Gauss?
Yeah, the last one.
Gauss?
Yeah, the last one. I love them.
I made them up.
Oh.
I hope you don't even say you don't seem very concerned.
I'm not. I don't know much at all. What is it people say? I know what I want. Well, I don't even know what I want. I just heard you're a hot tip, so here I am. I'm Maddie Stone, you're all and you're in. Or so I've been told.
I see. You're an investor.
That's an ugly word. Not that I hang one of these on my wall, of course. No, I have to put it away somewhere. No offense. So, what's this? Let me guess, a representation of the human soul as it seeks for an inner meaning? Still life with Rioja?
No, that's the wine I put out with you.
Okay.
Can I pour you with that?
Yeah, just the one, I suppose. You're very kind. So does one train for what you do?
I spent 3 years at the academy.
3 years? Gosh, what do you do?
The disciplines, the techniques, school of art, emotional expression, contrast of form, perspective, color and shade. It's all about the tyranny of self-censorship and how to overcome it. And that was just the first term.
You learned all that?
Amongst other things, yes. It was a very intensive course.
Just to paint? I mean, isn't it easy?
What are you doing?
I'm standing like an artist. Isn't this how you stand?
No.
So how do you stand then?
You just stand normally.
That's disappointing.
So, what do you paint?
I think I'm going to paint a landscape.
Are you a Christian?
No. Not really. I'm not really good at impressions.
It's an art form based 19th century France.
Is it?
It's all about the depiction of light in magnifying glass. Taking an ordinary subject and including movement to it as a human perspective and experience.
Yeah. Yeah, okay. I guess I am an impressionist.
Where do you start?
I think you're gonna start with the shape of a hill or something.
So, this isn't a real place then?
No, it could be. Green hill against the blue sky.
Green?
Yeah, green for the grass.
Ah, grass is green, is it?
Of course.
Come to the window. Look. See the grass?
Yeah.
What color is it?
Green? Don't say a word. Details, right?
Details.
There's a mixture of things going on here, isn't there? No, I don't say anything. I get space, I get wide open space, and it's disciplined, like patchwork fields. It's like we're looking down at the earth from above. We're flying. There's a line going through the middle by the top and the bottom. This is fun. Could I have another glass? Perhaps a whole new career awaits me. No, I was wrong. They're not fields, they're boxes. Compartmentalization. How we put our little lives in little boxes. Crap, that's what I would call it. Boxes. Am I close?
If you like.
I don't say that. That's such a cop-out. Don't tell me it means whatever I want it to mean.
It's true.
Well, what did you mean when you painted it?
Fields. The rock. Mantis strata from age oldest at the bottom. Like a cross-section world.
Oh.
In that middle? That's us.
Us?
You, me, all of us. Do you ever wonder what the world would be like in a million years?
Not really.
The Earth's crust is half a mile thicker, and everything the human race and machine all under one such a rock layer, all the tablets, gadgets, houses, cars, all reduced to 1 mile thick of non-biodegradable plastic, and Mother Nature will pick up from where she left off before any of us came along.
That's rather bleak. I hope it has a cheery title.
Fertility.
I'm afraid it's failing me.
Maybe. You need to be open to new ideas and experience.
Are you?
How's it going?
Show me your best pieces. Point out the most expensive, so I knew which one to take.
How would you do that?
So, which one is it? Out of interest.
It's, that one.
Cursed. That surprised me.
So, now that you know, what would you do with me?
Do?
Now you know what painting you're after. You get me out of the way. Think I'm just gonna let you walk out of here for your $1,000 worth of art?
I'd come back at night once you left the gallery.
I don't know, upstairs.
You'd be very quiet.
No, I know, don't play. I move the paintings out, we can put these here for when we come back.
Yeah, I suppose that is a problem. Silly me.
The textbook mistake. If you were the thief, what would you do about that? Not that I know.
I'll tie you up.
With what?
Existing footage, and if the robbery isn't discovered by this time tomorrow, there'll be no recorded evidence. To be safe, I'll get my hair cut and dyed. I'll wear dark sunglasses, like in the movies.
But I can recognize you. Your car, the way you look, your clothes.
Yeah, I suppose I would have just compromised my plans by telling you my position. I'm not very good at this.
You have to help me. Don't tie her tight.
I didn't mean to.
So you're just painting the car and drive away? You're leaving here?
Yeah, I suppose so. Job done.
But what if I just hit the car and I stopped the alarm?
Why would you do that?
Because I have my suspicions, and I don't want you getting away.
Have you disabled my car?
It's not the most expensive piece, by the way.
Oh?
No, it's that one. And it's not worth $30,000.
So, now I know.
Discovering a third person's body outside the city as in many days. Spoken urges all citizens to see what you expect inside the hours of darkness. You're so scared, why don't you listen to them?
It's not dark.
And not be unaccompanied.
Not unaccompanied, you're here. You said yourself it was safe.
All three bodies have been found outside the city, beyond the countryside. Please urge all citizens of the city to be especially vigilant.
Do you think I might be the murderer?
What's a murderer look like?
Oh, I see. You're still playing the game, aren't you? Oh, you really had me. I was beginning to think I was the murderer. So, where does it come from?
Life?
No, that spark of inspiration, that moment of creativity that leads to these paintings. I never had it. Where does it come from?
When's the last time you gave yourself a morning to gaze out the window at a tree or cloud?
since I was a boy.
How's that time you give yourself a measure of time to create something new? Those are time of inspiration. If you really want it, you go looking for it. Just pop some by when mine's empty. But as we get older, you start playing games.
Is it divine, do you think?
Not really. I don't believe in poetry. It's a pressure valve.
Pressure valve?
Way of getting the animal inside out. Sometimes it's better to acknowledge the darker side of our nature. Paint it, sculpt it, whatever it takes.
Is that what you do? You're painting?
Perhaps I do.
And what does it feel like?
Maybe your marriage.
How long have you gone? It started off well. She was rich, which was important. Pun in hell. I thought it was a match made in heaven. You know when two people compliment each other? I mean when they go together well. Well, that was us. She was blonde and beautiful. Did I mention she was rich? Wow, the things she bought me. We were married for 3 years, starting to think of having a family. I found a bitch's book.
Book?
She kept a book. Diary, I presume, but with more of a scrapbook. Pathetic. It's a collection of men. Each page different from the other. Notes, comments, receipts, photographs.
Receipts for what?
For the gift she bought for each of us. Yes, I was in there too. Not a very flattering photograph, I must admit, but if I known I was going to have a page in her portfolio, I might have at least done my hair. I confronted her about it, asked her what it was all about. She said she couldn't help it. She was a collector. You know how in the old days, when people would pin butterflies on a board? That's what she would do.
Wall collectors, really? Memories, experiences?
Looking back, it was easy to see. I found one of the gifts she bought for one of them. Sam, his name was. Found a watch one Christmas in a drawer. A beautiful thing. White gold. Like a fool, I thought it was for me, so I carefully put it back in the box, shut the drawer. I didn't say a word. On Christmas morning, there was no sign of it.
And how did you know?
I found the receipt next to his name in the book. That's when I demanded a divorce. I felt like killing her, but divorce is all the law allow.
Wow.
There were other clues, of course. Smell of somebody's cologne around her neck, midnight messages to her phone. I ignored them all until I found the book.
We all do that, don't we? Close our eyes to see what we should really see.
Oh, I made a life out of it. So I'm here, man alone with no one for company but my Spanish tutor. She only comes twice a week.
You never heard of me before, have you? Hmm? When you arrived, you said you were a big fan.
Oh.
But you've never heard of me before, had you?
No, I wasn't very convincing, was I?
So, why are you here?
I might not have heard of you, but my lawyer has. He said you were worth investigating. You're very up and coming. So, here I am.
And do you like it? My work?
That's irrelevant, really. It's interesting. I think I can grow to like it.
Did you do it?
Do what?
Could you actually murder somebody? In cold blood, I mean, not by accident or in war or anything, but could you actually murder someone?
Depends.
On what?
On whether they deserved it?
No, I mean just for the thrill.
Suppose so, yes. See my strength, see my eyes. Body limp in my hands.
It'd be an artistic experience.
Artistic?
As an artist, I need to be open to any new ideas that might inform my work.
Even murder? I don't think I could do it. As much as I might want to, I don't think I could.
Or perhaps, maybe I'm just worried that I might get caught. Is that it? Is that what stops us? Not the act itself, the fact that we might get caught?
I think you'd get away with it, if you were clever.
What would you do if you were
a murderer? What?
How would you engineer murder? My murder.
Well, why would I want to murder you?
I don't know, for the sake of the game. Say you were a serial killer. You couldn't help yourself. Or maybe you even did it just for the thrill. Something sexual, perhaps. I don't know, what would you do?
I'd sit like a spider in a web, waiting for the right one. I'd get your hair long, just see my paintings. Make sure no one knew you came.
Well, you've come around there for a start. Marta would miss me. I called her where I was going, left her the address.
No, you didn't. You left in your bag by mistake. Details?
Very good, I'll give you that one. But how would you do it?
I'd get you drunk. But in such a way you wouldn't notice until it was too late. I'd toy with you. Have you ever seen a kitty with a mouse? It's almost as much fun to the pursuit of the killing itself. I'd get to know you a bit.
Why?
You were not to, and you would give me power over you.
What power?
Let alone a secure compound. You're obsessed with the used baggies. You can't help yourself. You drive an old car that you're undoubtedly trying to replace with your settlement. The tire on the rear side is low, but you're not good with your hands, so you've left it. You've been married once for 3 years, and even though she treated you badly, you still let her run away. Your pole is all your left shoe, big enough to let water in, which means you're only working with fine weather. And your tiny scar of your right eyebrow, which you can only see if you're very close. I found it quite near. Pay attention. You said only have one glass of wine, but you didn't even finish the whole bottle. Details escape you. It escaped you in your marriage, and it escaped you today. Now, what do you know about me?
You're an artist?
Am I?
You must be. You said so yourself.
Did I?
You must have. Beyond that, I have no idea. You must be, what, 30?
Not even close.
Well, then I don't know anything about you. How come you know so much about me?
Because it bleeds from you. You want to be liked.
But we all?
Not really. I don't care what people think of me. I exist on the outside looking in.
Outside what?
Everything.
Okay, so you've got me here, got me drunk, and no one knows I'm here. So what now?
I tie you up.
Just like that?
Why not?
What if I didn't let you?
Oh, you'll let me.
How can you be so sure?
It's like power. You've already shown me how.
Go on then. Ow, you're being rough.
I know.
You're hurting me.
Yes.
I know.
It's quite tight. So, what would you do with me?
I'd beat you. Maybe with a bottle of wine and set off the body.
What about the CCTV?
Wire inside, easy enough.
And my body, what would you do with that?
Take you with me in my car. Drag you out to boot. The miles from nowhere, so no one would see me. Bury you in the desert. Told me to live alone, so I doubt anyone would know we ever met.
I phone for help.
When?
I phoned for help when you were outside fixing my car alarm.
No, you didn't.
Okay, you've got me. Consider me dead. You win. Can you let me go now, please?
There's something you've missed that I've been trying to tell you.
What?
People never stop to look, do they? People never stop to look at the details. Describe your journey here today.
I got lost, I told you.
But what did you see?
See? Some trees, some cattle by the road.
Is that it?
Let me tell you some things I've seen over the past few days. 3 days ago, it was hot. Pearl Ailey fell onto the floor. Glenn Miller on the radio. Sound of the shower covered her screams. Took her down to the surface elevator. Don't turn, making her bad. Next day, city streets. Followed him on foot to the park. Knocked his phone from his hand. Shook one scarf at his neck. Buried him in the mountains.
Help!
Yesterday, I stopped a car with foreign plates. Pulled her from her car and she struggled. Buried her near the lake. See, I know you've never heard of me before. Never seen any paintings?
What?
The fortunate thing is, this all happened by accident. Fortunate for you, that is, I wasn't the spider in the web waiting for my fly to appear. I already don't want anything to do. You took me by surprise.
What are you talking about?
You missed all the details, Sterling. There's something you missed that could have saved your life.
What?
Did you feel safe knowing it's just you and me?
You said yourself it was safe.
But it wasn't just you and me. Think. Think of what you said when you arrived.
I asked if my car would be okay. I parked around the back.
What did you see?
Another car?
Wrong?
Saw two cars.
Wrong again.
Help!
She's gonna point a fight.
I told you.